Hello, hello, hello. Happy Monday. I'm going to give everybody a moment to join. Make sure that tech is cooperating because we all know how that goes sometimes, especially on a Monday. Hello, hello. If you are joining, pop into the comments and let me know that you're here. Oh, I think I see people joining now. Hello, happy Monday. If you're on the East Coast, happy afternoon. Welcome, welcome. Just giving people a minute to join. Hi, welcome. Nice to be with you. Welcome to Massive Shift Monday. It is a weekly session I do. It's pretty self-explanatory to help you have a massive shift in the way you are thinking, feeling, believing, behaving, so that you can contribute to the growth of your business with more ease, flow, confidence, and results. My name is Kelly Ruta. I was a former a clinical psychotherapist for 20 years, working very deeply, safely, and expertly with people's hearts, their minds, their trauma, their beliefs, and their behaviors. And about 6 years ago, I made a huge leap of faith from a very comfortable space that I thought I was going to spend my entire career in, into a very unknown, very uncomfortable space, also known as the online entrepreneurial space, because of several reasons. And that's really what I'm here to talk to you about today, which is liminal space, which I'll get into in just a minute. Hello, if you're just joining, please say hi in the comments. Let us know you're here. So glad you're joining. And really, the power of being in a very, very uncomfortable space as you grow as a business owner and CEO, and as your business is in the process, the very freaking messy, uncomfortable process of growing and scaling. So, as I mentioned, I left a 20-year career as a clinical psychotherapist, very comfy in a beautiful, completely 100% full, booked out with a waiting list, private practice to both answer a calling that I heard and to fill a gap in a space that. And for those of you who know me, you know I don't mince words. It freaking appalled me. It still does appall me. And that is the coaching space. I watch people every day. Everyone, their mother, their sister, their brother, their husband is a coach these days. And that's fine. And that is wonderful. But I watch a lot of coaches do work with entrepreneurs, especially with women who. They do mental work, they do emotional work, they do trauma work, they do behavior change work with zero expertise in any of those fields. And when I mean expertise, you know, there's varying definitions of that. But when it comes to working with the human psyche, the human brain, human behavior change, and really reinventing yourself, which is what CEOs have to do over and over and over. Not working with an expert is a super dangerous thing. I'm just going to put it out there. It's going to piss a bunch of people off, and I am totally cool with that. Because after 26 years, I've seen far too much damage and far too much pain inflicted by well-meaning people who are not well-trained people. And so I'm here to make a difference in that. So I part of the reason why I got into this crazy, wonderful space is because I do bring real expertise and the practical applications of things like psychology and social work and neuroplasticity to the entrepreneurial world at a time, again, when everybody and their sister calls themselves a coach. And even the International Coaching Federation is offering things like a 3-day, $1,000 workshop to become a life coach. This infuriates me. To no end. So today and every Monday, I try to bring my 26 years of education, experience, training, supervision, certification, practice, everything to you to help you navigate that space of being a CEO and entrepreneur, especially as a woman, to help you navigate it with more ease, more speed because time is the one thing we can't make more of, and a lot more grace and joy. So today I'm super excited to talk to you about what is known in psychology and anthropology and religion and a bunch of other areas as liminal space. Liminal space is that super uncomfortable in between space. And I want to tell you a little bit before I teach you about it and how you can navigate it better. I want to tell you the truth, which is that I am in a super uncomfortable liminal space myself right now, in my life and in my business. I live with a chronic illness that I've been managing for 6 years, since 2015, so 6 years. I am revamping a business to answer the calling in a bigger way, to serve people better, to have an incredible team. After having been, I guess the best way to say it is profoundly let down and disappointed by some people that I have worked with. I am working full-time while I have two kids that are navigating their own liminal spaces right now as teenage boys during a pandemic with ADHD and other challenges. I'm in every liminal space known to man and woman. And I think it's important for me to share that with you because I can show up and teach, I can show up and guide, I can show up and give you tips and tricks and, you know, strategies. And I think in the online space, especially in social media, you can get a glimpse of somebody who looks like they've got it all together, who has a successful business, who maybe has some things that you desire to have or is in a space that you desire to be in. And it's really easy to come to the conclusion that just because somebody looks well put together and is making good money, that they have all their shit together. And so a commitment I have made since day one in this business is to be extremely uncomfortably vulnerable and transparent, not from a place of I'm falling apart and things are a mess, but from a place of normalization and validation for anybody who's watching and for anybody who works with me. I think this is incredibly important. So while I'm going to teach you about what's called liminal space today, which is that uncomfortable in between space, I want you to know I'm in it with you. I'm in it with you. So liminality, liminal space, it's a term that is really used to describe this psychological process that we go through of transitioning across the borders that we have in place right now into an unknown space, a space where we've left something behind, a lot of things behind, but we're not yet fully in that next space of something else. It's a space of transition. Now, as I mentioned, this term exists in lots of places, in religion, in psychology, in anthropology, across many, many fields of study and research. But it applies to business. It is profoundly important that business owners and CEOs of growing and scaling companies understand this process. So every business owner, from their first year to their last, is going to experience multiple times where you are in a very uncomfortable liminal space. And in this sort of online space, we often refer to that as the new level, new devil experience. Or some people will say it's a time of hitting upper limits and ceilings. Maybe you've heard of it referred to that way. It doesn't really matter what you call it. What matters is that you recognize it, you're able to be in it and navigate it incredibly well, and you're able to come out of it on the other side with the ability to take forward action and create momentum that grows both you and your business. So liminal spaces for CEOs and company owners exist really of two things. Number one, the space between who you were as a CEO or solopreneur or company owner before and who you are becoming, and the space between what your business was and what it is becoming. And I bet that many of you are in that right now. It is a profoundly challenging and uncomfortable space. Now, businesses that are growing and scaling already past, you know, their first few $100,000 are going to enter liminal spaces that will literally, please listen to me. I am not exaggerating. I am not one to, you know, be dramatic and drone on. This is really important that you listen to what I'm saying to you so that you know that what you're going through is so incredibly normal. But if you're in that space where, you know, you've moved past, I don't know, 250 or 300K and you're rapidly or attempting to rapidly scale your business, you are, what you go through when you get into that transitional space is going to challenge every thought, every belief, every relationship, every dream you have ever had, every strategy and tactic you have ever used to create results up to that point. And when those things are challenged, you will be triggered. You will be triggered. Self-doubt will come up, fear, scarcity, old self-sabotaging habits, and contraction of who you are, which often shows up as, huh, I don't feel like submitting that article. I don't want to go live. I don't want to write my book, start my podcast, submit for that TED talk, do that big joint venture. But the truth is this, liminal spaces are full of limitless possibility when you learn how to navigate it like the badass you are. They can become spaces of absolute infinite innovation, creativity, growth, service, financial abundance, joy, all the things that make owning a successful business mind-blowing and wonderful. Now, CEOs and company owners really have one choice to make when we find ourselves in this liminal space. I have had to make this choice every day, I don't know, three times a day, at least, since I got sick with COVID last year. And for those of you who don't know this, I got COVID in July of last year. I was in bed for 60 days, and then I was unwell until the first week of January. I still have some lingering cognitive symptoms because the infection went directly to my brain instead of to my lungs. And so I'm a COVID long hauler. And it has challenged everything in me, everything in me. And so I've had to make this decision multiple times a day, every day for the last 8 months. And that decision is this: will you embrace the power of the uncomfortable space of transition, of the being in between, or will you resist it? Because it is so profoundly triggering and uncomfortable. That's the choice you have to make every single day. Now, most mindset coaches will use cognitive reframing, which is a great technique. I used it in psychotherapy to help you think better feeling thoughts and then kind of cope with being in that uncomfortable space. They will make pop culture references to things like law of attraction, or they'll use journaling to help you ease your discomfort. And none of those things are inherently wrong. They can be, in the moment, helpful. They are what I like to call nice icing on the cake. As long as you're okay with there being zero substantive cake. If all you want is the icing, then go work with somebody who's just going to do that fluffy feel-good stuff. But it's not going to take you where you need to go, how you need to get there, as fast as you would like to get there. If you do not learn how to, in a strategic, practical, vetted, meaningful way, master this transition process, it's going to take longer. It's going to be far more painful. It's going to cost you more money. It will leak joy from your business and from your life. It will profoundly contribute to your experience of burnout. It will feed those thoughts of, do I deserve to? Can I really do this? Am I worth this? Is this even possible? Why the hell am I doing this? And it will also trigger one of the biggest mistakes that I see in the entrepreneurial space, which is getting busier. I see too many female CEOs who equate busyness, B-U-S-Y, busyness, with worthiness in business. Busyness with worthiness in business. Because when you're triggered in this in-between space, what do most high-achieving, ambitious, intellectual people do? Work harder or learn more? And by work harder, I don't mean on themselves. I mean on their strategies, their tactics, their marketing, their funnels, their sales process, all which deserve development and investment. But this will never, ever be the resolution to the new level, new devil experience. Never. So think about it for a minute. How many times have you found yourself in this profoundly uncomfortable space that I share with you right now and ended up buying a course, hiring a business coach, a sales coach, a marketing coach, or something like that, making a strategic business building investment to get you out of it, when what you really needed was a way to invest in your own development, a meaningful way, not this fluffy surface level bullshit, my friends, a deep science-based, strategic, meaningful way to learn the skill set of navigating this universal experience. So you can apply with more speed, in a more pragmatic, practical way, all the things your business coaches have taught you, already taught you. Because if you're at 300, 500, 750, seven figures, you've got a great business coach. The thing in your way is you. So the truth is your business is only going to grow to be as healthy and high functioning as you and your team are. And if you are not a confident, clear, in command CEO, how do you expect to attract, vet, hire, train, onboard, and up level a team to be? Those very same things. You have to shift out of only making investments in your strategy, sales, and marketing, and into the CEO you are becoming in this space if you want your business to grow with more ease and if you don't want to backslide in that space. Because look, we're human. You can only tolerate discomfort for so long before you sabotage and backslide, because your ego wants you to go back and be in that comfort zone. Even if that deep yearning in you is to get out of that comfort zone and leap towards the calling. So if that's you, and if you're still with me or you're catching this on the replay and you're still here, I suspect that it is you. And I want to remind you, sister, I am with you. There are four things that you can do today. Now, I want to remind you, this space is uncomfortable for everybody, but I move through it with less suffering, less struggle, and more speed because this is what I teach people to do. So I practice what I teach, what I have researched, what I preach, And then I apply that to what my business coach, Kelly Roach, teaches me in terms of strategy, tactics, and how to build a successful business. So I'm not in my way. I am invested in my own development. I'm invested in the development of my business. There is no either or, friends. There is no either or. You have to be living and operating in the space of and. And that is a scary space. But you know what? Building a seven-figure or eight-figure or multiple six-figure, whatever your goal is, building a successful business isn't for the faint of heart. That's just the truth. So here are the four things that you can do today. Number one is just fess up. There is no shame, none. There is no shame in fessing up that you are struggling with this in-between space of growth, and give yourself a freaking pass on it. Guilt and shame will never, ever contribute to the growth of your business unless you happen to be coaching on how to overcome guilt and shame. The struggle is real. It's valid. It's natural. It's normal. It is also unavoidable. It is unavoidable. Now, you can mitigate it, but you're not going to skip it. And wouldn't you love to? We'd all love to. So the next best thing to skipping it is saying, I admit that this is where my struggle is. There is no shame in it. And just like I went and got help in my sales, my marketing, my model, my hiring, my advertising, whatever, I am willing to invest in doing the same in the development of myself as a CEO. Number two is, please know in your heart of hearts that on the entrepreneurial business building and scaling journey, this experience is unavoidable. And the reason, there's a very valid reason, the reason it's unavoidable is that it is innately human to be called to grow and expand. Innately. We are not biologically or psychologically wired or designed to stay in the same place in business or in life. That is why you resisting being in the in-between is so damn exhausting. You cannot bypass the human experience. You can only learn how to mitigate it. Number three, and for those of you who are new to me, I use language. For those of you who aren't, this is not going to be surprising. I want to look you in the eye and tell you this. Remember who the fuck you are. Remember who you are. When you get off of this live stream, get a piece of paper immediately. And I want you to make a list of five times in business or life when you were in a scary, tenuous, threatening, or seemingly insurmountable situation, and you found your way out and you didn't quit. You may have pivoted. Maybe you slowed down. Maybe you made a new decision, but you didn't freaking quit. And lastly, when you think of those five times, if you have more than five, listen, by the way, because you'll look, come up with a list of 10 and then come back to me and try to convince me that you're not a badass. Try to convince yourself. You're not going to be able to do it. And when you think of those times, ask yourself this question. This is a really important question. This is where you bring it down to the ground and make it practical. What would it have been worth to you if you were able during any one of those times to navigate that really messy space faster, easier, with more support, with less shame and fear and guilt, and come out of it with a brand new skill set that allows you to face the next time you get into a liminal space and transition through it with more confidence, command, and speed without losing your mind, losing your money, or losing your team? What would that have been worth to you? That's the question. If that is what you know you need. If this is speaking to you in a way that's making you feel both optimistic and hopeful and kind of like you might throw up a little bit, I invite you to reach out and DM me today. Tell me about your experience. Tell me where you are. Tell me what's going on. And let's talk about whether or not you are going to make the choice to stay in resistance, drag this on longer than it needs to go, or if you're going to make the decision to lean in, stop resisting, and finally develop the skill set to navigate this, because this won't be the last time. It won't be the last time. And when you learn to navigate these messy, uncomfortable spaces, that's when they become messy, uncomfortable, and fucking magical. That's what I want for you. So while here, the way I want to wrap this up is, yes, I'm in this messy, uncomfortable place, and the freaking mind-blowing, magical things that are happening, the people I have attracted into my business and life, the support that I'm getting, the new ideas, the innovation, the creativity, the connections, there, I couldn't have dreamt them up. I couldn't have dreamt them up. So it's messy, uncomfortable, and magical, which for me as a CEO is exactly where I know I need to be. It's exactly what I know I need to transition through so that in my business and in my life, there is a massive explosion and movement forward. And then I'll be met with another liminal, transitional, uncomfortable space. And I will navigate that the same exact way, right into more beautiful, abundant outcomes. So I invite you to DM me. I am in my own DMs. Occasionally my team is in there. If they're in my DMs, they will let you know it's them and not me. But I encourage you to DM me and tell me, did this resonate? What's going on for you? What has this experience been like? This new level, new devil, you know, upper limits, in the middle, messy as fuck experience been like for you? And if you're on the edge of burnout or giving up, even though you've made incredible amounts of money or progress, it's time, my friends. It's time. So thank you so much for joining. If there is somebody in your business, your life, who you know needs to hear this message today, please tag them in the comments so they can catch the replay. If you're catching the replay, please let us know. Just use the hashtag CTR so we know that you swung around and listened to this. If you have any questions, pop them into the comments. Myself and my team will circle back around, as we do every single Monday, to see what you had to say. And if you're ready to take action — actually, ready is a bad word. You're not ready. If you decide to take action because you know you've struggled and suffered enough, send me a DM and we'll talk about it. All right, friends. As always, thank you for being here. Thank you for listening. I'm going to send you off into the rest of Monday and your week with so much love.